Remember, an ACL is per object or per resource. It tells us user ID, what access that user has, and then the next user ID, what access that user has, and some number of entries like that. And by the way, access control entries, or ACEs, is what they're called. So where should ACL for an object O be stored? So first of all, this has to be stored in the trusted part of the system. It has to be stored in the operating system or the trusted computing base, because it actually determines who can access a resource that needs to be protected. If it's not in the trusted part, then some untrusted code or application potentially can change it. But where exactly does it go in that system? So we know that it is a list of these access control entries, and this is for a given object or a resource. Such a list exists, an ACL exists for each resource. So we have resource R is going to have an ACL R. One natural place for us to store this ACL is where other information about the resource or the object is stored. So the other information, typically what we call, is metadata about that resource. So if the resource was a file, for example, metadata might say the size of the file, where on disk it may be stored, who the owner is, and things like that. We can store the ACL along with that other metadata that you have. So we're going to do an example for Linux-like system, Unix systems, how file system access control is implemented. And we're going to see that the ACL information actually gets stored same place where metadata about a file is stored in the operating system. We said metadata has a bunch of other information where ACL is going to be stored as well. So then the question is, how do we use this information? So remember, for an object resource, if somebody is going to use it, the object or resource has to be activated so it's ready for use. The metadata has to be acquired. Something has to be set up in the operating system. And once that is done, then the request is going to come. So at that time, we have to perform a check, access control check, to decide if the request should be granted. So how do we perform that access control check? Let's say it's coming from Alice. The request source is, we know, is Alice's UID, and the request is for file foo. We're going to go to the metadata for file foo, where we're also going to find ACL for file foo. And once we have that ACL, we basically have to traverse it looking for an access control entry for Alice, and then see if the access rights in that ACE grant permission to this object, to Alice, in the manner or what kind of request is being made. So for example, it's read of a file, then does the read access right exist in the ACL or the ACE that we have in the ACL for user Alice? So traversal basically says, when a request comes from a given user, we have to go down the list to see if an ACE exists for the source of the request, and if it does it include permissions consistent with the nature of the request? And if that's the case, then we can grant access. If we can't find such an ACE, or the access write doesn't exist, so there is an access ACE that says you can read, but the request is for write, then also we're going to deny it. So now we understand how ACLs can be used.